I borrow an egg, I'm baking a cake and I'm short one. What's the matter? Are you sick or something?
No, I spent the day with little Ricky in the park. I am suffering from a disease common to mothers of three-year-old children. It is called poopitis.
Oh, he really gives you a workout, doesn't he?
He never stops running.
Well, is there anything I can do for you?
Yeah, help me put my feet up on the couch.
Okay, honey. Oh, you poor little thing.
Gosh.
Want me to take off your boots?
No, thanks. I'll take them off later. Help yourself to the eggs.
Okay. I hope you feel better after you've rested a while.
Hi, Ann.
Oh, hi.
What are you doing lying there with your coat and your boots on?
Motherhood.
Lucy!
Relax, dear. I meant motherhood of a three-year-old child.
Oh. Did Ricky give you a tough day?
No, just the same as any other day. After breakfast, I put on his snowsuit. I pull on his galoshes. I slip on his mittens. I walk him to the park. He chases the pigeons. I chase after him. He runs after the squirrels. I run after him. He gets on the swing. I push the swing. We go on a teeter-totter. He teeters, I totter. And we leave the park and we walk home. I pull off his galoshes and I pull off his mittens. I pull off his snowsuit. I fix his lunch. I put him down for his nap. And he sleeps for a whole half hour.
Well, that sounds
very... After his nap, I put on his snowsuit, pull on his galoshes, and I pull on his mittens. We walk back to the park. He chases after the pigeons. I chase after him. He runs after the squirrels. I run after him. He gets on the swing. I push the swing. We get on the teeter-totter. He teeters. By now, I'm really tottering. We leave the park. We walk home. I pull off his galoshes. I pull off his mittens. I pull off his snowsuit. I tell him to go in his room and play with his teddy bear. And that is why you find me sitting here with my coat and my boots on.
Wow.
What's the matter with you?
I'm worn out from just listening.
Honestly, I'm so tired I could scream.
Well, go ahead and scream. It'll do you good.
Oh. I'm too tired.
Honey, it's just silly for you to get this tired every day. Little Rick is 3 years old now, and there's only one thing to do.
Now, don't start that again.
What again?
You want me to send him to nursery school?
That's right.
Well, I won't hear of it. He's entirely too young.
You said that 6 months ago.
And I was right. We're just going to have to wait until he gets older.
How much older?
Well, until I feel he's old enough to go to nursery school.
Well, he's going to look pretty silly playing in a sandpile when he's 30 years old.
Now, honey, don't be funny.
Now, look, it's not fair to the kid. He needs children his own age to play with.
He has plenty of playmates.
Who?
Me, Ethel, Fred.
Well, Fred and you and Ethel are not exactly little Ricky's age. Although at times you act like you were.
It may interest you to know that one of the world's leading authorities on baby care does not think he should go to nursery school.
Who's that?
Dr. Spock. I've been reading his book ever since little Ricky was born. Now, this is what he has to say on the subject. I quote, "A good nursery school does not take the place of home." Well, there.
Well, that doesn't sound right to me. Let me see that book.
I told you what it said. What's good enough for Dr. Spock is good enough for me.
Let me see the book, if you
don't mind. Why do you want to see
yes,
the book?
Let
I told
me,
you what
let
it
me,
said.
I want to see the... You didn't quite finish that sentence. A good nursery school doesn't take the place of the home. It adds to it. Most children benefit from a good nursery school. It is particularly valuable for the only child, for the child without much chance to play with others, and for the child who lives in a small apartment. That's what the good doctor says.
Well, what does he know?